everybody, it's Lurgs here. Welcome to my channel. And today, how to transfer everything from your old iPhone to a brand new iPhone using the iCloud. Now I'm going to be using the free iCloud 5 GB of storage. Let's get cracking.
I personally don't use the iCloud for backing up photos and videos because it takes up a lot of storage. What I do is I move them onto my computer, and there's a link above now about how to transfer photos and videos from your iPhone to your computer. On the left hand side is my old iPhone 6, and on the right hand side is my new iPhone 8 Plus. And I want to move everything from the iPhone 6 to the iPhone 8 Plus. Now the best thing to do is make sure that the operating system is completely up to date on your existing iPhone. So go into settings and make sure that you've got the latest iOS update. And on this one, it's iOS 12. Now I'm just going to speed up this footage massively because this does take a long time. And whilst I'm doing this, there's a link above now about how to transfer voice memos from your iPhone to your computer or laptop. Okay, so this is about 10 or 15 minutes later and the iOS update has completed. So I'm pressing the home button to finish setting it up. Then you'll need to put in your Apple ID password. There's a few screens here that you can set up or set up later. And welcome to the iPhone. Now go into settings. Now to transfer things from your old iPhone to your new iPhone, you will need the Bluetooth on. Once we've done that, then just select your ID at the top. Scroll down, click on iCloud. As you can see, I've not used any of my 5 GB of storage on my existing phone. So scroll down and you've got iCloud backup. So click on that. And it's not currently switched on, so let's turn that on and start the iCloud backup. And now we can select a manual backup now. Now this takes absolutely ages. I didn't back up any photos, it's just data, so WhatsApp, messages, contacts, things like that. And it literally took over 20 minutes. And my iPhone 6 is saying the last successful backup at 1350. And there's a link above now about how to print multiple pictures on one page in Windows 10. Now I just make sure that the Bluetooth is on, which it is. And now what I'm going to do is turn on the iPhone 8 Plus. And as long as the phones are next to each other and the Bluetooth is on, you will get this message on the left hand side saying set up the new iPhone. Now on the right hand side, I'm just going to select my language, which is English, and then the United Kingdom. And then on the existing iPhone i6, click on continue. This is now trying to connect to the new iPhone. And there we've got the message waiting for the other iPhones. You need to pick up your old iPhone and then use the camera and scan it over the swirly blue swirly circle thing, which is all part of the security. And there we go. Now we've got a message, finish on the new iPhone. So on the new iPhone, you need to put in your existing passcode, which is the passcode from your other iPhone. Now we're just going to set up the Touch ID. So this is putting my thumb on it at various different angles, so it stores the fingerprint. And there we go, that's complete. Now it's setting up my Apple ID. And here, it's asking what backup I want to use to restore onto this new iPhone. So I'm going to pick the one which is from today at 1350, the 8th of September. So just click on that and then click on continue. There's a few menus to go through here. And then it's asking for the latest software update, so I'm going to do that as well. Again, I'm going to speed this up massively. This can take 5 to 10 minutes. Whilst I'm waiting for that, there's a link above now about how to take screenshots in Windows 10. So the new iPhone is just rebooting. and installing the latest iOS update. Then it's going to ask for the passcode again, so you need to put that in manually. You'll notice the message at the top to begin restoring the backup, enter your Apple ID password. So let's just do that. And it's saying you made some purchases with a different ID. I'm just going to skip this step. Yes, skip that. And now it's going to restore from the iCloud. So this is taking everything that we took off the iPhone 6 on the left and putting it on the iPhone 8 Plus. Again, I've speeded this up massively, and there we go, look, they look absolutely identical. You may have to put in your password for your email settings and possibly for your WhatsApp and any other apps you might have. Whilst I'm doing that, there's a link above now about how to speed up your iPhone by clearing the RAM. We've got a message on the old iPhone saying that the Apple ID and phone number are now being used on a new iPhone, which is correct. As you can see, they're looking absolutely identical. And then the next thing you need to do is just remove your old SIM card from your old iPhone and then put that into the new iPhone. This is for your mobile carrier. I'm actually with Asda Mobile. So just push a little paperclip in there and it just pops out. This is a micro SIM. Remember to put the old holder back in the old iPhone. Push the paperclip in there and it should just pop out. There we go. So lay the micro SIM in there. It can only go in one way. It's got a curved edge on the top right hand corner. Just slide that in gently. Put it back down and switch it on and give that 5 or 10 seconds and it should pick up the carrier. And there we go at the top, it's saying Asda Mobile. So that's all looking good. Now the next test is just to ring this phone just to make sure it's definitely transferred my number across. Everything else is looking perfect. So let's just give it a ring. And there we go, absolutely superb. It's definitely time after that for a lovely cup of tea.
Oh. If you would like more videos on how to save you time and money, then please press the subscribe button down here. I really do appreciate you visiting my channel, everyone. If you'd like to select any other videos around here, that would be really cool. And be sure to hit that bell notification tab. Yeah.